And I'm handing over to James Kent now, who has made this beautiful film that we're so proud of.
Thank you. Thank you, Rosie. Thank you, David. Yes, it's my first feature. Gosh. And it's a kind of thrilling to have it here tonight, primarily for two reasons. The first is that, this is London. It's the London Film Festival. It's the biggest festival in the United Kingdom. And this is a British story. I mean, from London, 900,000 young men went from our great train stations and never came back. From London, Vera Brittain loved, and she continued to live here for quite a while. It was very special in her place. So it was from London that we conceived this film, shot some of it, cast it, edited it. So I cannot think of a better place to launch Testament of Youth than at the London Film Festival. The second reason why I'm absolutely overjoyed, my cup overfloweth, is that this is the film I really wanted to make. It truly is. And that's rarer than you might think in the filmmaking industry, that a director says that at the end of the race course, if you like. I'm extremely proud of it. And I couldn't have done that without the support of my two producers, fabulous David Heyman, an extremely wonderful Rosie Allison. And it truly was a privilege. I couldn't have done it either without this incredible cast. Just look at them. First time feature director. Absolutely fantastic. And you will actually be hearing from Alicia all the way from New Zealand in a clip that we'll play later. After Shirley has spoken. So I would like now to hand over to the most important lady in this room, who is Shirley Williams, daughter of Vera Brittain.
Thank you. Thank you very much, James, and thank you all for coming. Let me say, having listened to the mayor, that I have to say if London was not the premier centre of the film industry yesterday, it certainly is today. Let me also say that it's been for me a great pleasure indeed to see the amazing dedication and comradeship of this particular group of men and women. The actors, the director, the co-producers, the sponsors have all been committed to this film in a way which is quite unusual. They've been committed to the idea of the film, to what the film tries to say, and not just to the possibility of having a film or fill the box office. I'm greatly pleased with them. I want to thank them very much indeed, not least for the friendship between them, which is not always common and which is extremely impressive with this particular cast. And let me say finally that, as you will see in the film, the combination of the comfortable material world of Edwardian England in the fading years of the 19th century, followed only a decade later by the descent into hell, which was in effect what the trenches were, the discovery of vile creatures, dying bodies, people who were dying and even drowned in the mud of the trenches, is to bring home the horror of that war. And as we once again celebrate the centenary, we also have to recognize the extraordinary courage of those young men and women who fell in that war, many of whom had no idea of what they were getting into. We have to thank those who came out of it, as my mother did, saying they were going to change the world for something better. And we should end by watching a film to say to ourselves, we must try to bring war to an end. Thank you for listening.